Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Anna Mugesha. The channel is bringing hope in life. In case you're new in this channel, welcome and feel at home. This is where we speak hope in our experiences. I have started a series of relationships. In case you have not watched episode 1, this is episode 2 of Relationships with Anna Mugesha. Please do subscribe. Connect with the first episode so that we can go together in this journey of relationships. Today, I want to talk about what makes up unhealthy relationships. What are the characteristics of unhealthy relationships? When we talked about healthy relationships, we talked about what you, as the members of that relationship, you do. The opposite of what you do is what makes up these unhealthy relationships. It's good to note that most relationships will have these unhealthy characteristics, but unhealthy relationships will exhibit more of these unhealthy characteristics or characters frequently, which may cause the members a lot of stress and a lot of pressure, which is hard to avoid. Remember, this tension of unhealthy relationships will make you or affect you or bring problems in other parts of your life. For example, you find that your family is affected, your friendship is affected, you find that you're also affected in your place of work, and you find also that through these unhealthy signs which keep on coming, which are frequent in your relationships, you are not productive anymore. So what are these signs of unhealthy relationships? How do you know that you are in a toxic? I like calling it toxic because, trust me, unhealthy relationships can cause harm and pain in someone's life. It is no longer supportive. So these are the signs that make up these unhealthy relationships. Sign number one. When you find that as a member of the relationship, you put one person before the other by either neglecting yourself or neglecting the other partner. That means you no longer take care of yourself. If you find that you have changed who you are to fit in the other person's shoes, to fit in the relationship, that means you are an ape. You have aped somebody else. You are not yourself, so that you can fit in that relationship. Then you should know that is a sign that your relationship is becoming unhealthy. The other sign is that when you try to manipulate each other, these are the normal things that make us feel that we are not happy in our relationships. Manipulative skills come. You find that sometimes you have to explain your actions. Where was I? Who are you with? What were you doing with that person? And that means it is a sign that trust is eroding or trust is going away. If you find that you are unable to resolve small things, minute stuff, and conflicts are not resolved fairly anymore, it becomes abusive, it becomes physical, it becomes violent, then that is a sign of unhealthy relationship. You find that a small argument, a small disagreement becomes violent and like I called it in the first episode, a really of screaming and yelling at each other. The other point is that when you feel worried to disagree with your partner, all with the other member of that relationship, that means you will swallow everything, bitter or sweet, because you just don't want to argue. You're worried of arguing, then you are in an unhealthy relationship. The other point is that, like I've said, you feel the pressure to change yourself so that you can fit in the other ones. Sorry, nikona mwa Kenya hapa. I am trying to get the points so that you can get them clear. and you understand whether you are in a healthy relationship and how you can start rebuilding it. Arguments are not settled fairly. That is what I've just said. When you notice that one of you want to justify your actions, where were you? Who are you with? What were you doing? The relationship is becoming unhealthy. The other ones are the obvious cases that we people assume. And remember, assumption is not the best thing. For example, all of a sudden in this relationship, you have started criticizing me about my behavior, my actions. You criticize everything, my dressing style, you have started criticizing. Then take care, it is becoming toxic. The other one is when you lack respect of each other. For example, communication is key in a healthy relationship. When you stop communicating, remember communication is verbally, using the cues, body language, and all that. Are you able to listen when somebody is talking to you? Are you able to read through body language that something is wrong? When communication becomes talking at each other, yelling at each other, then respect is not there. The other thing is that when in that relationship, you lack time for each other. There is no ample time that you take to build this relationship. Then if you assume it, these are the small things that we assume, and we eventually find ourselves very unhappy with our relationship. So if you notice you have no time for each other, especially for the romances one, the marriage and all that, if you find yourself that you have no time for each other, then take care, because soon enough it will be a sign of unhealthy relationship. Unequal control of resources. Food, money, properties, etc. and etc. I have done a video on money matters in relationships. Please, if you haven't subscribed, subscribe and watch and see what I talked about, his and hers, in terms of money. So when you find that you have an equal distribution of resources, that when you start talking about money, money issues becomes an argument, you have control over the other, probably you get more than the other, and it becomes a way of bringing the other party down, then you are in the danger of unhealthy relationship. And so what we say when we talk about unhealthy relationship, does it mean that we are coming to an end? No, we are not coming to an end. These unhealthy signs can be worked upon to make them positive. You can work on improving these unhealthy characters of unhealthy relationships. You already have the positive part of healthy relationships, and you can make these signs which are unhealthy in your relationships healthy. Improve them. Improve the negative part of that relationship. Rebuild your relationship. Rebuild your marriage. Bring back your joy. If your heart is down, raise up your heart and build these unhealthy relationships into healthy relationships, because it does not mean this is the end of everything. So those are the signs of unhealthy relationships. Where are you? In which part of the relationship are you? Remember, these unhealthy relationships may have the positive ones, but the most of the characters that are in these unhealthy relationships are unhealthy signs. So are you able to build your relationships? Are you in unhealthy relationships? Do you feel that you need to talk to someone? I am here. I mentor relationships. I talk to relationships. I talk to individuals. Contact me and leave me a comment. Tell me you want me to hear you out, and I will be able to help. Have you subscribed? I still appeal to you. not to leave this video before you subscribe to the channel, before you like the video, before you share the video, and let's help have these healthy relationships. So subscribe, leave me a comment, thumbs up, share the video, and become a part of this family. May God bless you. May God build your relationships into healthy relationships. Toodles. I will be back.